through the night, dwell in his promises, walk in his light. Love water. I think a lot of times people mistake religious duty or religious upbringing for personal relationship. They put everything that's part of our faith and relationship with God into a religious category, so they always separate it and set it aside as though it has to be something that's oh so holy or not part of everyday life and not practical and for some reason. And the more that I come into contact with people, the more that I realize that they really don't put into practice their religious life into a practical reality where every day seeking God or asking him what he would have you to do. For me, I can't imagine reality being anything but having a relationship with God to the point of having him involved in all that I'm doing. I mean, if you know he lives inside you and you know he's alive, then how can we dare but not have him involved in every day of our lives? That to me is what being a Christian is. In daily life, I am with you to save you. Shall the prey be taken from the mighty, or the lawful captive delivered? But thus saith the Lord, even the captives of the mighty shall be taken away, and the prey of the terrible shall be delivered. For I will contend with him that contends with thee, and all flesh shall know that I, the Lord, am thy Savior and thy Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob. Fear thou not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen you, yea, I will help you. Yes, I will uphold you with my right hand of my righteousness. We have not a high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. In that he himself hath suffered being tempted, he is able to succor them that are tempted. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his ways. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholds him with his hand. What more can we say to these things, except that if God be for us, who could be against us? And why should we fear anything that man might do or that we might fall into if we just turn ourselves over to the reality that God is involved in our lives? He's involved in mine. I hope he's involved in yours. He did create this universe, you know. It's kind of hard to pretend like he's not real when everything screams out that he's not only real, but he intervenes. He satisfies the longing soul and fills the hungry soul with goodness. You have tasted that the Lord is gracious. O God, thou art my God. Early will I seek thee. My soul thirsteth for thee. My flesh longs for thee in a dry and thirsty land where there is no water, to see your power and to see your glory. My soul longs, even faints, for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God, having a desire to depart and to be with Christ, which is far better. I shall be satisfied when I awake with thy likeness. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more, neither shall the sun light on them, nor any heat. For the Lamb which is in the midst of the throne shall feed them, and shall lead them unto living fountains of waters, and shall God himself shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. They shall be abundantly satisfied with the fatness of thy house, and thou shalt make them drink of the river of thy pleasures. My people shall be satisfied with my goodness, saith the Lord. If you don't have and you don't possess, don't worry about it. If you are impoverished, which I have been most of my life, and though what you see now may appear on a video to look like something important, over here is a milk case. Everything was on sale. everything has come by way of pennies. And the goodness that God has for you and the greatness that God is bringing you through may cause you at times to think that you don't have much. But the reality is we have so much more that's coming that you have no idea what eternity is going to be like. So don't lose heart. Don't grow faint or weary. Don't get disappointed. God is with you. God has promised to take care of you. And God has said He will deliver you. And since He said it, He'll do it.